Hello everyone, we are going to see how to customize Ubuntu or any other distribution. So recently Ubuntu has released 14.4 and let's see how to customize the operating system. So what I have done is I have downloaded a 32-bit version. Just copy the link and just obligate the link and it will start downloading. I have already downloaded, so I'm not going to repeat this step. So what we are going to see is first we will try the default CD on a VirtualBox. VirtualBox is a virtual machine which emulates a PC, so you can test virtually any other operating system. We call it guest operating system on your native host machine. So this is my host machine. So let me search VirtualBox, fire it up, and so this is the VirtualBox settings page, and here I have some other distributions. So I will take the live one. I will go to settings, storage, and yes, so it's already there. So you can either you can choose from this list or you can just add from here. It's that simple. And I have set a virtual base memory of 512 MB, a video memory of 32 MB. You can set whatever you want. So as my machine has 4 GB of RAM, so I can allocate whatever less than maybe 1 GB. So let me fire it up. Okay. So now we are in virtual machine. So this will take some time, and when it's done, you will see a yep. So here we are. So it's an Ubuntu 14.4. You can see Ubuntu distribution. Yes, 14.4. Let me try whether I can zoom in or not. Probably not in this window. No. Okay, anyway, so here we have our default LXDE menu, etc. So what we will do is we will try to add a VLC player to this and also add some local dev files. So let's see how to do that. So you can either turn the virtual machine off or you can continue your customization. So I don't need my CPU to be consumed with VirtualBox. Fine. So to customize a live CD, so we need a kit. We need a tool which is very popular tool, which is UCK, Ubuntu Customization Kit, Fire Ubuntu Customization Kit, and wait for it. Okay, okay, so you need to select a language. So I don't want any other languages to take space in my CD, live CD, so I'm removing the other one. So please choose language for live CD. So English is good enough. I don't know why it's asking me again. Okay, it's a default one. So now it asks me which desktop environment I want to customize. So I don't have Unity, GNOME or KDE. I have LXDE, so I will choose others. Now it is asking me the path of ISO file. So let me go to my ISO images. Yeah, a lot of ISO images here. Which one? Okay, we were doing Ubuntu, right? Come on. Yep. Ubuntu 14.4 desktop. Fine. You can name anything. So let's say Srikant Ubuntu 14.4. Done. Do you want to customize the CD manually? Of course. That's the whole purpose of the story. Windows files typically I would like to, but let it be there. Do you want to generate a hybrid image? No, I'm a normal guy. Okay, now it is asking my sudo password. Given my password, it is unpacking the ISO image. So technically it is doing unsquash fs. So all these live CDs have the squash fs file system. So this will take some time and we'll see what happens next. Okay, why we need this menu bar? Just turn it off. So it will take some time. Meanwhile, we can see how to add local dev files. So this unsquash fs process will create a directory, and it will be something like in my home directory. Okay, let me walk through the directory structure first. ls-lart. So this will print the latest directory. Okay, in temp. So in home directory, UCK creates a temp directory and it creates a remaster u and remaster app cache, remaster new files. So these new files will contain the newly created ISO image at the end of the process. This apt cache is the directory which is interest of us. So whatever dev files we keep here, that will appear inside a chroot environment, which we will see right now. I hate this Unity feature. Okay, let me close this. Okay, so unsquash fs is done. UCK is updating the package repositories, so it understood that whatever we are going to install, we need fresh repository namespace. And my internet is quite fast, why it is taking so much time? Anyway, getting fine. So yes, let me open a new tab here and let me walk through the directory structure again. So it will create a directory known as temp in my home directory. Pwd, I am at home. Cd temp. I already have a temp directory, unlike you fellas, because instead of having system temp, I also prefer having a temp in my home directory. Okay, so in my temp, I keep all my local unnecessary files. So remaster tool, UCK remaster tool, it also creates some directories inside a temp directory. So they are remaster tools. Okay, so we get remaster apt-cache directory, remaster root, and remaster home. Fine. So the updation of packages has been done. Now UCK is giving me an option that what I want to do. So if you remember, let me just minimize and show you this. So it has updated the package repository and it also removed all other languages except English. So this will save some space. How much? This operation gave me 111 MB free space. Okay, so if I am good with this, I don't want to customize any other thing, then what I can do, I can just do continue building and okay, it will create a new live image without these language packages. But we have a different thing in mind. What we'll do, we'll do run console application. So this will give me a chroot access of this device, this live CD. So the unsquash fs root file system live CD. Yeah, that is correct. So my aim is to install a package, say VLC, which doesn't come pre-installed in Ubuntu. And I also want to install my local dev file. So I usually do a lot of live CD stuff, and one of my favorite live CD is stuff ISO Linux and XSPICE essentials. So XPy is a open hardware open source tool for learning various science experiments. You can just go to xpy.in for more info. And here we have a lot of depth files, local depth files, and in particular I want to install XPy 3.1 on my live CD. So what I will do, I will just copy, let me clear the screen, I will just copy this XPy depth file to my temp remaster tool apt-cache. So apt-cache is a directory which contains all the local depth files. So to copy I need sudo access, because we have opened UCK tools using sudo, of course. Done. So now coming back to my, this is my UCK console, the chroot environment. So once I have done with VLC, I can install my other tool also. Let me install VLC first. It doesn't matter, you can install anything. Okay, we are almost done. So after installing VLC, as we have seen, so we have copied our XPy depth file to remaster apt-cache. What does it mean? It means this remaster cache directory is nothing but our chroot directory, which contains /var/cache/apt, which is the default system directory where all the depth files from repositories accumulate. So you can see at your local directory also, ls/var/cache/apt archives. So this contains all the depth files. Okay. So similarly, in the chroot environment, we have the XPy depth file. So this is the live CD chroot environment. So what I'm going to do is cd /var/cache/apt. Let's see. Yes. So here we are. So this particular directory var cache apt is been mounted as ls/temp/ls/remaster/apt-cache. Yes. So this directory in my host machine is same as this directory in chroot environment. So whatever I copy inside this directory will appear here. So this XPy I'm going to install, I will just use gdb-m non-interactive XPy. Done. Okay. So it requires some packages. Fair enough. And gdb will take care of all the dependencies and other stuff. You can also install using dpkg-i, but that doesn't resolve dependencies. And yes, let 15 minutes. Why the speed is so low? And let me check out. And so it's done. Almost. Just trigger the libc. And man pages. No. Okay, it's installing lot many stuff. Like Python NumPy, this is a huge package. Python CD is not a big one. What else? Okay, whatever. Yeah, it's triggering MandDB. Will it trigger libc? I don't think so. Okay, anyway, so our next step would be, so our this step was adding from, sorry, adding a local depth file. I should have put in B instead of putting in, doesn't matter. So yes, finish it fast. And yes, and we are done. So I will just do exit or control D to come out of this chroot console. And again, I get the same menu. Suppose I forgot something, I can do get back and do run console application again. But no, I am satisfied, and I will do continue build. And if you come to this page, will show what it is doing. So it is downloading some stuff, and it's done. So it is packing the square surface image back, and of course our previous ISO size will be smaller than our present one. So let's wait for it while. Okay, so the build is complete and it's giving me an option to run in a Kemo. I like Kemo. Okay, anyway, we will test in VirtualBox. This is a graphical thing, I don't want to scare you with command line options. Let's see. So where is our new file? As I told you, it will be in remaster new files. Let's go and grab it. And oops, so this closed my that terminal and remaster new files. Yes, it's there. Let me check the file size quickly. 646 MB. Okay, what was my earlier file size? Where is my file stuff? ISO images and L Ubuntu, is it? Yes, 14.4 i386 for 684. Can you tell me the difference? It should be larger than 684, right? Because we removed some language packs. Remember that 114 MB? Oh, that made a big difference. So after installing VLC and XSPICE along with all those Python, NumPy, etc., still we could manage around how much? 38 MB less than. Is it 38? Okay, whatever. Do the calculation. Now we'll try in VirtualBox. I think I have opened VirtualBox somewhere here. Yes, VirtualBox. Go to settings. And storage. And instead of this, what I will do, I will choose a live CD. I know the path is correct. You can see here, remaster new files, etc., etc. Press OK. Start. Enter. I don't want to wait for 25 seconds or so. Let's see. So we are in this third step. Let me just highlight. I don't know why I'm doing this, but I like kind of this quick recap, so you know what all been done and what is the next step and previous. It's kind of the idea, and I think it's booted quite well. Let's see. Yeah, I can close that. Done. Okay, let's go to menu, sound and video, VLC is there, and let's go to education. You can see the XSPICE and XSPICE Junior, etc. Fine, that's all about this tutorial. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.